Hello and welcome to the latest Lukozer retro game review video. And for this one, it's a game that I wouldn't normally do. This is Revenge of the Mutant Camels, which was something of a classic Commodore 64 game. And Jeff Minter then decided to do an Amiga version in 1991, which he released as a Shareware game. And so I don't normally do Shareware games, so I wasn't going to bother with anything like this. But I am prepared to make an exception when it comes to Jeff Minter games, and particularly when said Jeff Minter game is Revenge of the Mutant Camels. I had the original, I had the original Attack of the Mutant Camels, then I had Revenge of the Mutant Camels, and then I had Revenge 2 for Commodore 64, and they all got better and better and better until Revenge 2 became one of the best Commodore 64 games I had. Anyway, let's get a game underway. Let's just check the options. I want the totally psychotic. What options have we got? High score and stereo phasing. Right, well, we don't need any of those, so let's just go back. Let's get the game underway. Let's play now. We'll play it from the beginning. Now you can have the CPU assist, or you can be completely solo, or you could have two player. Now I'll have the CPU assist on purely because it will show you a different mode compared to what you've already seen before with the Commodore 64 version. If you had the two player mode, then the CPU assist is actually playing the part of the second player, so that's what the two player mode is all about. Anyway, so let's get a game underway. Now your camel automatically fires, so you don't have to actually do anything. If you hold down the fire button, it changes the direction that you fire at. So if you hold down the fire button and push up, then you can actually jump, or you can actually fire up rather than jump. And I grabbed that icon that was the cigarette, and now I'm sort of, it's acting as though I'm a bit spaced out on the, well, let's put it this way, it's clearly not a cigarette that he's smoking. Bearing in mind who wrote this game, right, I'll grab that as a power up, so take that. I have no idea what these Q icons do. There's also another icon that appears later on which has like an apple on it and stuff like that, and it's all just completely bloody mad like any other Jet Mini game. So there you go, there's that P. Again, I don't know what the P does, but I'll grab it anyway. I'll grab that. That's another power up. I think that P resets, because when I grabbed it last time, okay, obviously it doesn't. Anyway, we've got through that level. Now, the shield that you have isn't quite as easy to see this time compared to the Commodore 64 version. But it is there. If you look at the top, oh bollocks! I'm gonna say if you look at the top corner, you can see, you're just about to make it up where it's showing. So I grabbed the apple. I don't know what the apple does. The Nike obviously makes you move faster. I don't know what the pumpkin head does. There's all kinds of power-ups here. I have no idea what half of them do. I'll try and get that. I did get it. I really want that one. There we go. I don't remember this one, actually. Let's see what that does. It looks quite useful. Anyway, we're now on to the next level, or the next stage. Can't remember what it's called. I think it's called Attack of the Mutant Camels. Well, let's grab a few more power-ups while we can. So, let's just do the actual review part then, and the, it's, oh, bollocks, I picked up the wrong power-up, it's the one where your controls get reversed. I mean, as, you know, Amiga games go, it's not great. I personally don't even think it's as good as the, Commodore 64 version of Revenge of the Mutant Camels. I mean, it is typical Jeff Minter insofar as, you know, the gameplay is just insane, extremely heavy on the special effects, both in terms of visual and audio, you know, they're just pretty mental. Here we go with the next level. Wacky Whackers, this is the one where they're all walking sticks, and I think a lot of them come along from behind. Whoops, I didn't want to be jumping. There they are. Oh bollocks, I fucking jumped again. So yes, you know, crazy sound effects, crazy visual effects, and you know, in a way, yes, the game does play very similarly to the original Commodore 64 version, but it's just not as good. It just doesn't grab the interest so much. That Halo gives I have temporary invincibility, so now I can jump up and down. So I mean, as a game, it's reasonable, but it's certainly not Minter's finest. The fact that it's a shareware game, you know, certainly works in his favour. Oh yeah, so this is the Attack of the Mutant Camels level. Yeah, the fact that it's shareware certainly works in its favour. It means that, you know, you haven't spent a fucking fortune on a game that, to be honest, is very basic. Power-ups. I'm trying to keep these, because those fuckers, if they hit you, that take a hell of a lot from your shield. Whereas if you do keep shooting at them, you get a hell of a lot of points for them. So this is like a save area, so if you remember that name, you can then start from this area again. An interesting way of filling the mutant camel with water. And away we go again. So yeah, essentially you could get this game for nothing. I mean, I didn't have this game back in the day. This was... it was blind luck actually that I happened to find it when I did. I was completely completely oblivious to this game's existence. This is despite the fact that I was a big fan of the I think that's game over. Yes, it is. Forcing us to do this fucking arcade style. Oh, fuck it. You know it's me. So there you go. I mean, it being a Shareware game certainly helps to bump up its score, because you didn't actually, you know, spend any money to get it. But nevertheless, you know, one quick go and you score 4.2 million. So you can certainly rack up the scores without actually having paid anything. When you did pay for it, I am assuming you can't still, you know, actually register it anymore. Although, I dare say that, you know, if you got hold of Jeff Minter, he would probably, you know, quite happily let you. And it adds some additional features. I can't remember what any of them are. But it is what it is. It's you can certainly see that this is the sort of stepping stone from his Commodore 64 games to the completely over the top PC games that he's doing now, or he did now. I don't think he does PC games anymore. And here we have the sort of like halfway point between the two, and it shows on the Amiga. So I would give this game 6 out of 10. It's not as good as the classic Revenge of Mutant Camels. It's certainly not as good as Revenge 2, but it's not terrible. And considering it's free, unless you want to register it, you can't really complain. So there you go. That is Revenge of Mutant Camels for Commodore Amiga. And that brings this video to an end, and obviously we shall see you at the next one.